Assalamu alaikum, my name is Rana Muhammad Zulkarnain. Today I am going to discuss about Lowry and Bronsted concept. This concept was proposed by two scientists independently. One is Lowry and one is Bronsted. According to this concept, acid is a species that gives proton or have tendency to give proton. Its example is HCl because HCl has tendency to give proton. For example, HCl have tendency to give proton, so it is acid. On the other hand, base is a species which accept proton or have tendency to accept proton. Its example is NH3. NH3 is ammonia because NH3 have tendency to accept proton. NH3 accept proton to form ammonium ion, so NH3 is base. And next is conjugate acid or conjugate base. This concept also involves the concept of conjugate acid and conjugate base. Whenever a weak acid or base dissolve in water, conjugate acid or conjugate base is produced. Now we will see how conjugate acid and conjugate base is produced. Conjugate acid is formed from base by gaining proton. This is Bronsted base. NH3 is Bronsted base because it has tendency to accept the proton. When NH3 accepts the proton, it forms ammonium ion. Ammonium ion is conjugate acid because it has one additional proton and it has now tendency to give the proton. So it is conjugate acid and ammonia is conjugate base. So conjugate acid is formed from base by gaining proton. Next we will discuss about the formation of conjugate base. Conjugate base is formed from acid by giving proton. For example, HCl is acid. HCl give its hydrogen and conjugate and chloride ion is conjugate base. So conjugate base means chloride ion is formed from conjugate acid mean hydrochloric acid by giving proton. So it means we are seeing that HCl gives this proton and form conjugate base. Next we will discuss about the neutralization reaction. The neutralization reaction is the reaction in which Bronsted acid react with Bronsted base to form conjugate acid and conjugate base. For example, this is Bronsted acid, hydrogen sulfide and H2O is Bronsted base. They both react with each other to form H3O positive and HS negative. H3O positive is acid and HS negative is base. Next we will discuss about amphoteric substances. This concept also involves the concept of amphoteric substances. The species that can accept as well as give the proton are called amphoteric substances. Water is an example of amphoteric substances. For example, these are the two reactions of H2O. In one reaction, H2O react with NH3 and in this reaction H2O is giving its proton to NH3 and NH4 is produced. In second reaction, in which HCl and H2 are involved, in this reaction, H2 is gaining the proton and forming H3O positive. In first reaction, H2 is giving proton. In second reaction, H2O is accepting the proton. So, H2 have equal tendency to accept as well as gain the proton. So, it is amphoteric substances. Amphoteric means we do not have a concept that it is an acid or it is a base. Like in one reaction it is acting as acid and in the other reaction it is acting as base. So it is an amphoteric substance. Advantage. This concept is superior to Arrhenius concept. So this concept also explains the acid or base that is not explained by Arrhenius concept. Its example is NH3. NH3 cannot be explained by Arrhenius concept and is explained by Lowry and Bronsted concept. NH3 is a base. So according to Arrhenius concept, the base are the substances that can give a hydroxide ion, but NH3 not have any hydroxide ion, so it cannot be explained by Arrhenius concept and it is explained by Lowry and Bronsted concept. Like some advantages, this concept has also some limitation. The basic limitation of this concept was that this concept is not applicable on organic compound. On the other hand, another limitation was that the compound that are occurring as acid in one reaction are also occurring as base in other reaction. So